So I got hit with American and Ferris, not knowing the excerpt at all. And again, that's tears, embarrassment, hiding my head under the pillow at night, being afraid I was going to lose my job. What I did is I bought recordings of everything, everything I could possibly find, because Duff didn't teach with recordings. We didn't have ensembles. We didn't have any formal program outside of the lessons where he would come over and teach us the lessons. You know, that's why you're so great that you've got a full program here. He couldn't. He was 30 miles away, you know, just to be able to get here. That's what made it so difficult at that time. So those are some of the things that were my own experiences with Floyd Duff that you'd asked for me to share a little bit. And I put a tribute to Floyd. It's not there to come up, but I put a tribute to Floyd on the website that was written by Jim Atwood when Floyd was nominated in the Percussion Hall of Fame in 1977. And that gives him a much deeper look at Floyd, and then you have also the YouTube video that'll round it out as far as your experience, if it's a first experience for you. Now, I'm going to do one of these unfolding, admit to you what happened, and then let you have that one-time experience here. For the sake of time, and in order to do the snare drumming the way I would like to, I'm only going to do one performance of this, but I'm going to let them look at the music. So, actually, while we're passing out the music, let's do the first performance of it, and that's the one where you see where you see Floyd and the Dick Firth and Paul and Mark Yonkish going by. I think it's where we have the video set right now. And I'll pass the music out, and then I'll tell you what happens on the music, and then we'll play it again so you can just watch and listen. So don't worry about finding your way on the music right now. Just get it passed out and just kind of listen to it. But let me tell you what happened on this. I debated releasing this ever because this was done many years ago with a single overhead microphone. And this was four dressed in timpani with a single overhead microphone in a concert hall, big open wide concert hall. And you can't record timpani that way. I mean, you just can't even begin to record them that way. But we did, because it was part of a recital. So what this is a concerto for timpani. And what happened on it is my pianist was a phenomenal pianist. And my pianist decided that he was going to play the part from memory. So he plays the piano part for this from memory. As a result of playing it from memory, I got baited into playing my timpani part from memory. So I played the timpani part from memory, partially. Only what happened was, if you look at the timpani part, I guess I'm talking my way to the performance here. At 13, when you see the timpani part starting on this Allegro Moderato movement, it's supposed to repeat itself. It's 14 measures long. It's supposed to repeat itself a total of 5 times, because you see 13 through 14 measures is the first time, and then when you look down, 14 for 14 measures is the second time, and you see the little 4X down there. So you're repeating those 14 measures 4 times. Well, what happened is I repeated from memory, I repeated those 14 measures a total of 4 times, not a total of 5 times. So here I am. Only he's still coming through this getting louder section here over playing from memory. And he knew right where he was, but he couldn't make any change for me because he was playing from memory. And I couldn't make any change for him because I was totally lost. So now there's one more little caveat to this. We got through it, and it takes basically here and there coming in and out on the second page, which is 18 through 31, never released before to the public and probably never again except in private clinics. But by the time you get over to the next page on 32, right there and my ad lib section, we're back on. We're back on to the end of the piece. Okay? What I didn't know is that Floyd had brought the entire Cleveland Orchestra percussion section to my senior recital. And they were sitting in the back row. This was the first percussion recital that had been held at Oberlin in so long that it was quite an enticement. It was a concert hall of over 700 people that was filled with capacity. And I did get a standing ovation for the recital, and I did play, there's an advisement and all these other pieces you see here. So I think I earned the right to that. But this was a bad moment. Unfortunately, Floyd had never worked with me on this concerto. I didn't get to see him. He was, you know, he was traveling, and I had to put this together myself with Fred, my accompanist. So when you're watching this, don't be concerned that when you're following the music and you're glancing up and seeing the great timpanist, a good time to look for the great timpanist is about the time that three times go through on page one here. Then catch a few of the great timpanists that I've saved on the slides and flip the page and then watch and listen for 32, and then you can be back on and you can watch some of the music with the great timpanists just repeat themselves again. And if you get lost, don't worry, because I did too. Okay, let's give that a shot. And you just let it play. It won't follow the music, it will only follow the image of the side story, the rest of the story. All right, now, this is where I'd like to jump ahead because of our time and get a full experience for you. Instead of going to the rhythm section, I'd like to go to the snare drumming section. And we queued up on the snare drum. I think I forgot to tell you about that. When we were first setting up, it's from the DVD.
Okay.
It's at the DVD, right? Because that's where we picked up those other special effects. Okay. You cast that out. Here's a rudimental review. And then to save a lot of talking and literature for you to look at afterwards, this is concepts. And the concepts will contain the same things that I'd like to share with you to get you from the standpoint that you might be at right now to being able to do something rooted on the swing. I'm going to try and get a couple of people up here just to do a couple of very straightforward bits of playing, and then I'll pick up some solo and show you how to turn it into rooted on the swing. And we'll see what questions that brings about. So you'll have two sets of papers here. One's got extensive information on it that you can review afterwards, and hopefully it'll all be valuable to you. And I'm going to go through that, but we're going to play two more times for you now from what Nate bring up. And that's going to be the rudiment review. And I'm going to have you follow, if you would, from these rudiment sheets that I've just passed out to you. So first, you can check your chops. Check your chops against these. First time through, it's called moderately fast, and the